Jerrica Janeau from the new series on WOW TV, Jerrica in the Wild. How are you, Jerrica?
I'm doing fantastic. How are you doing, Rod?
I'm squeaking by, thank you. So very exciting. You've got your own nationally broadcast hunting show. So that's got to be awesome, right?
Yeah. It's a little nerving, but I'm really excited. We've been working on it for a couple of months now, and I'm excited to actually see it come to fruition. I hope everybody really loves it. But being on TV is super new. So
it's a bit of an adjustment period. So by trade, you're a nurse.
I am.
And at the same time, you're an outdoors person.
Yes.
So there's something kind of unique about the show that you're creating right there, obviously. But what exactly, what are you doing with your show? If it's like, is it just a regular hunting show, or what are you doing that's different maybe than anything else that's on TV right now?
So definitely not a regular hunting show. I'm a late to the game hunter. So I didn't actually start hunting until I was in my 30s. It was something that I started doing after I got sick, and I really wanted to get into it. I've been involved with hunting people my whole life. My dad hunts, I come from a family of hunters and trappers, but I never did it on my own. And it was something that I really wanted to be able to do to be able to provide for my family and just kind of like a bucket list thing. So this show, I'm not a pro. You see a lot of hunting shows where people are out there and they're like professional hunters. They're doing all these amazing things. I'm learning. So I'm actually taking people with me as I learn certain things. Also showing you guys some of the knowledge that I've acquired over time, be it modern technique, traditional technique, going with different cultures, different hunters, different lifestyles, just all over the country, and kind of showing you guys some different methods. And also it's very field to table. So not only am I showing you guys the actual hunting process, but I also show you processing the animal, what I do with the hides, what I do with the meat, some cooking, again, the foraging aspect of it. So it's a little bit of everything. And then you also get an inside look at my family. So I have 6 kids, and you get to see a little bit of that, a little bit of my clinic, a little bit of the teaching and charity work that I do. I'm kind of all over the place. So it's a hunting and lifestyle show showing my chaotic existence.
Well, I think that's awesome. It's,
I'm really excited.
Yeah, it's always good to add a little more to these shows where it's not just, you're sitting in the bush, you're like, okay, there it is, that kind of thing.
And
I watch a few hunting shows and I find them to be relaxing. It gets me away from politics for sure. But being able to, like for somebody that's a non-hunter, being able to understand how to hide an animal, I don't think they show field dressing on TV, but how to process a lot of the other stuff would be valuable, like at least to somebody like me.
I think it's really good too, because it's showing people how to utilize all of the animal, which is a really important part to me ethically, to use as much as I can and have no waste. So showing people what to do so that they're not wasting those parts of the animal, or even what they can do in terms of donating it to people who can use it, just so that they feel as though they are utilizing as much as they can, which to me as a hunter is very important.
Yeah. You're also working, speaking of the shows, you're working with a friend of mine, Corey Levitt, who was involved in producing the second season of the CCFR's Canada Downrange, and a lot of other projects that we've done with Corey. But Corey's really, really good, and the stuff that he produces is excellent. So it's kind of exciting that you're working with Corey.
Yeah, no, it's been fantastic. I'm sure that he's probably sick of me right now. because again, I'm new to the game and he's very experienced. It shows in his work. He's phenomenal. I've watched a lot of the shows that he's produced, and it's just incredible the things that he's able to put out. So I know he's going to do the show justice. I have watched a couple of the episodes, and I'm so, so impressed with the way that he was able to bring our idea and make it work. He's been phenomenal and very, very important in this entire process. So I'm super thankful for him, and I'm hoping that we're able to continue producing this together and that we're gonna make some magic.
Yeah, that's awesome. So is it airing now, or when does it air?
The first episode airs tonight, actually. I believe it's March 29th. So Wednesday it airs at 7 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And then it airs again on Thursday, I believe at 11:30, Friday at 2:30, and Sunday at 6:30. And that's all Eastern Standard Time across the board.
That's very exciting. So this show lags kind of the podcast by a week. So when people are watching this now, it'll already be in rotation.
Yes. So there's a new episode every other week. So they'll still be able to watch the first episode next week when this podcast does air. But yeah, so, and we have 4 airtimes during the week, so you should be able to catch it. And then I'm also going to be having it available on a Patreon platform that I will make available to people on my social media.
That's awesome. Now you're involved with a lot of different things, not just the television show and not just having 6 kids and owning your own clinic. But you're involved in some charitable causes or various ones over the, across the past. What are some of the things that you're involved in?
You know, since I became a clinic owner and just being involved in my community, I've always really wanted to make sure that I had a way to give back. It's really important to me, being that I know where I came from. I wasn't always at the same level of privilege that I'm at now. So I like to give back to different programs. I've worked with women's shelters, mental health facilities. I've worked with a lot of Indigenous causes, and that is primarily where my focus is now, is helping different Indigenous communities with different, you know, issues that are going on, be it where it's the water boil advisories or maybe the homeless population. So I actually have an organization called the Falling Leaves Festival, where I do a fundraiser every year and donate those proceeds to an Indigenous-based cause. This year, we're still in the works of how that's going to look. But last year, we donated to Kettle and Stony Point First Nation. And the year prior to that was Chippewa of the Thames First Nation. So, really excited about that. I love that people are excited to get involved. It's a great way to learn about some of the important things that are going on that you may not hear about in mainstream media. And it's just really important to me to be able to give back.
Awesome. Okay, we're out of time. So where can people find you? We talked about how they can catch the show, but where do they find you online?
So you can find me on Facebook, Instagram, and TikTok, all Jerrica in the Wild. My name is spelled Jerrika, and then just in the wild, just exactly how it sounds.
Awesome. Well, thanks for coming on, and we'll have you on again.
Yeah, I'm super excited. Thanks for having me.
Remember, if you don't stand up for your own ability to own and use firearms, who will? Join the CCFR or donate right now at www.firearmrights.ca.